Hello everyone, so find here another video in our scripting series. In this video I will cover the binding of image over canvas with mouse. So this is one of the important activity in every GUI where we need to move the object with mouse. In my previous video I have discussed about how can we create image over canvas. Now here I will just simply put that a image is appear and how this image can move over the canvas with movement of the left click of mouse. Okay, so this implement drag and drop feature over the canvas. In this, for that I am going to take the help of two command. Command is bind. Bind command we have discussed in our previous video. Bind dot b1 motion. B1 motion in the angle braces, it is going to bind the movement of the mouse cursor and it will execute the simple task puts display pointer at %x %y, which display current coordinate of x and y of the mouse cursor over the canvas. Okay, so very first, let me look at here. This is my complete image we have. Over this image I am going to put canvas dot c. I am going to put -bg pink pack dot c. Okay, what we have seen, with canvas was created. Now over this canvas I am going to put the bind feature, bind dot c. Here I am going to put B1 left click of mouse with motion. It will execute a task puts or take the cursor statement is cursor at %x %y. This is a complete string I am going to execute with movement. Now what we have seen, there is nothing going to happen here. Now, but let me minimize it somewhat. If I left click here, now if I am going to rotate the mouse, the current location value of mouse will display of our console window. That is my standard output device. Since my left click of mouse is banded with canvas, it will display only at canvas. So when I am going to out of canvas, it is the display coordinate location is minus. It will display out of range. So maximum coordinate location which I can get and minimum coordinate location we can aim. So now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take the image first of all in my hard drive. I'm going to put certain image in my C drive active TCL bin folder. Here I have put two image and OR gate. The name is and.png or .png format. Now this image can be bind over the canvas and it can be movable. It can be moved along with click of mouse. Now let's see how can I do this. For that I am going to take the help of .c coordinate. .c coordinate is one of the command which will update canvas, which is going to update coordinate over canvas dynamically. Okay, very first what I'm going to do here now. Okay. Very first it will be better if I take the help of one notepad, because I'm going to take the help of notepad in this case. Okay, so on the notepad, first of all I'm going to create a command image. So as we have seen in last video, okay, image create photo. Okay, image create photo. The here I am going to give the name of the photo, it is and minus file and dot png. Okay, let me make some larger size. Okay, first of all I have created one and image. Similarly I am going to create one another image, image create photo or the name of the photo is all file by minus file or dot png. These two files which I have put in my hard drive. Now I'm going to create a canvas. canvas.c I'm going to put here minus vg. Suppose if I take red. Now I'm going to set two command. I'm going to use set and this is one. I'm going to add a temporary variable and or set and dot c create image dimension. I'm going to give 50 for the and minus image and. Actually, the next to make the image display over canvas, I'm going to use dot c create image. It has been stored into a temporary variable set and. Similarly, I'm going to use the set or one another variable. I'm going to use dot c create image. I'm going to give some random dimension minus image or. Okay, now after that I'm going to make it pack.c. Now next command is, next step is we have to bind. Now when I'm going to bind, we have to bind the dot I'm going to bind it now. So dot c bind, what I'm going to bind, actually we need to bind the complete image to be binded. So dot c, I'm going to give the bind command. So over the canvas I'm going to implement bind. Now complete dollar and, it will be get substituted, which will call the dot c create image. It means image will be create and binded with over the mouse cursor. So I'm going to bind it b1 motion. Remember here m will be capital. Now here to make it, I'm going to call a procedure move. I'm going to call a procedure in which I'm going to pass the object dollar and ampersand x and ampersand y. Sorry, yeah, I don't take a dollar, ampersand and ampersand. Okay, so I'm going to call a procedure which we will update it later on here. So I'm going to call a procedure. The name of procedure is move, in which I'm going to pass a variable and, that is my creation of image, and ampersand x, ampersand y, the coordinate location. Okay, now we need to define the move procedure. PROC procedure move. Here I'm going to call object, that is my and, x and y, that is my coordinate location. Now to make, to update the coordinate dot c, c-o-o-r-d, it is going to object, so it is going to update the coordinate of the object, in which case simply I'm going to put here the dollar x, that will be substituted, and dollar y. So dollar x, dollar y is my coordinate location coming from cursor of mouse. Okay. So now this similarly for the OR gate, I'm going to put the another image for second image dot c bind, the name of the variable I have put at the OR, and move dollar OR. Save this file with over the desktop. I'm going to save with 1.tcl extension. Okay. Now afterwards, call it the this. Console window, here we need to source the file over the desktop 1.tcl. Okay, now what we can visualize it here over the my this screen, over the this screen a complete GUI has been created over canvas, in which the click, left click of mouse has been banded with image. Okay, so left this in the every schematic tool, just when we're going for to compose some schematic, we need to drag and drop feature should be implemented. So drag and drop feature can be implemented with the following command. Command what we have done here, let me bind it all. So So very first I have put it here way image, create an image. Now to display the image over canvas, assign into a variable. Now here we need to over the canvas bind the complete variable with movement of mouse and call a procedure. The procedure, it is going to object or going to update the coordinate location individually. So finally we can implement here drag and drop feature wherever it will be helpful to construct or reshape the architecture according to our requirement. So I hope this video will be helpful for you, and in this way you can implement drag and drop feature of any schematic. Thank you everyone.